NCIS hidden secrets most fans totally missed. For about two decades, NCIS has really entertained and thrilled on CBS with its nail-biting case history. The team, captained by Special Agent Leroy Jethro Gibbs, has tackled anything and everything you can possibly imagine. Any criminal investigations that have to do with Navy or Marine Corps personnel fits into Naval Criminal Investigative Services and Gibbs' charismatic Agent Force. A spin-off from JAG, it's entering its 17th season and is still just as popular as ever. These days, the team is a little different with only Donald Ducky Mallard, the medical examiner, MIT grad Timothy McGee, and Special Agent Gibbs, Mark Harmon, left from the original cast. Through the irrepressible Agent Dinozo, feisty Agent Ziva, and lovable forensic scientist Abby have all left the show, they were part of the series for over 10 years and have a place in the hearts of all NCIS fans. Here are 10 hidden secrets everyone missed about the main characters of one of the longest-running series on primetime. Few shows have reached the heights that NCIS has. The popular crime drama on CBS has aired 18 seasons and has spawned multiple spin-offs, including NCIS Los Angeles, NCIS New Orleans, and a brand new spin-off, NCIS Hawaii. But the original NCIS just keeps rolling along. As it gets ready for its 19th season, NCIS, which debuted on CBS in 2003, was created by Donald P. Belisario and Don McGill, both of whom are still writing for the show. With these veterans pulling the strings behind the scenes, what can we expect from the latest season of NCIS? Well, time will only tell. What is the plot of NCIS? NCIS is about the cases handled by the Naval Criminal Investigative Service Agency from their Washington, D.C. office. The team is led by Special Agent Leroy Jethro Gibbs as they work together each week to solve a specific case. To start Season 19, the team will be dealing with an explosive finale from Season 18. Spoiler alert if you're not caught up on the latest episodes of NCIS. In the NCIS Season 18 finale, Ellie Bishop decided to go undercover with a sad goodbye to Nick Torres. Elsewhere, Gibbs believes that a serial killer that he has been tracking is following him. He persists with the investigation, though, traveling by boat to try and search for evidence when it suddenly blows up. Gibbs's body floats to the surface and appears to be lifeless, however, he eventually swims away. For now, let's move forward into NCIS's hidden secrets most fans totally missed. Number 10, Gibbs makes all the references to Mark Harmon. Mark Harmon plays Special Agent Leroy Jethro Gibbs, the no-nonsense leader of the NCIS team in Washington. Harmon was everywhere in the 80s and 90s, and the series frequently has references to his former projects. In the episode Chained, Gibbs keeps getting calls about a VW bug for sale. Exasperated, he asks the caller, "Do I look like someone who would drive a bug?" This references the time he played a serial killer Ted Bundy in The Delivered Stranger in Blowback. Gibbs is trying to solve a crossword puzzle. He asks Agent Dinozo if he knows the name of a TV drama that only has 8 letters. Tony's response, Saint Elsewhere. A reference to the series Harmon starred in as Dr. Bobby Caldwell from 1983 to 1986. Number 9. The Dinozo Head Slap Was Real. Michael Weatherly was recently single when he started playing Tony Dinozo on NCIS. At 31, he was separated from his former fiancée Jessica Alba and had developed a reputation as a ladies' man on set. Supposedly, during the filming for an episode, he was chatting up a young female extra, and apparently co-star Mark Harmon didn't take too kindly to see what was happening and stepped over to where the two were talking. He hit Weatherly on the back of his head, which the producers liked so much, they kept it in the scene. Later on, it would become a defining aspect of Gibbs and Tony's relationship appearing throughout the series whenever Tony said something Gibbs found offensive. Number 8. Pauley Perrette was basically Abby in real life. As lovable and stylish forensic scientist Abby Ciuto for 15 seasons, Pauley Perrette got to put her real-life forensic experience to the test. With a bachelor's degree in psychology from Valdosta State University in Georgia and a degree in criminal sciences from the John Kay College of Criminal Justice in New York, she had the appropriate background to give Abby real authenticity. In New York, she discovered her love for acting and put her master's degree on hold. Most of her interests and even aspects of her style of alternative fashion got worked into Abby's character on the show. Number 7. Cote de Pablo trained to be a linguist like Ziva. As Mossad Officer Ziva David, important liaison to NCIS, Ziva's background as an expert in half a dozen languages makes her invaluable to the team, as do her impressive combat skills. Playing an Israel Special Forces veteran wasn't easy and forced Cote de Pablo to become somewhat of a linguist. Not only did she work with a Hebrew dialect coach to nail the scenes where Ziva needed to speak Hebrew, she also trained to be able to rattle off other languages as well. Ziva was known for being something of a prodigy when it came to languages, so De Pablo had her work cut out for her. Number 6. Mark Harmon is basically Gibbs. Though Mark Harmon stepped to have a sunnier personality than his tough-as-nails alter ego, Special Agent Leroy Jethro Gibbs, there are many aspects of his personality that were worked into Gibbs' characters on screen. For instance, Harmon's father was a real-life World War II U.S. Army Air Force pilot, and so is Gibbs on the show. Harmon got interested in carpentry when he was a young man, and his woodworking hobby was passed on to Gibbs. In fact, most of the tools that Harmon uses in the scenes where he's working on building boats down in his workshop are all his. Number 5. Ducky and the Man from U.N.C.L.E. David McCollum played medical examiner Donald Mallard on the series since it began, offering his professional and personal advice to the team on everything from psychological evaluations to autopsies. He's known for his dry sense of humor and his amusing bow ties, often with eccentric patterns, red and gold elephants, or curious colors. In one memorable episode, Kate asks Gibbs what Ducky looked like when he was younger, to which Gibbs responded, "Ilya Kuryakin." This is a reference to The Man from U.N.C.L.E. in which McCollum played Agent Ilya Kuryakin, a role reprised by Armie Hammer in the 2015 film starring Man of Steel's Henry Cavill. Mark Harmon, Gibbs often called him Ilya on set. Number 4. Tony's Family Fortune Fiasco. Special Agent Tony DiNozzo has never had the best relationship with his family, especially in regards to his father, who never approved of his career. This is also very similar to the character he played on Dark Angel, opposite Jessica Alba, Logan Cale. Both characters were cut out for their family fortunes when they pursued their own life paths. This directly relates to actor Michael Weatherly's own personal family history. His father cut him out of the millions that he made importing Swiss Army knives when Weatherly decided he was going to be an actor. The bitterness and resentment between the two men gives the scenes between Tony and his on-screen father so much emotional weight. Number 3. Recycled footage. In the first few seasons of NCIS, footage was shown of aerial views of an aircraft carrier under Golden Gate Bridge. This is actually footage from the 1988 film The Presidio, an intense cop thriller starring Mark Harmon. Harmon plays ex-military policeman Jay Austin investigating the death of his former MP partner at a military base. It wasn't the last time Harmon would play a former military character. In The West Wing, he played Agent Simon Donovan, a role which garnered the interest of Donald Belisario when he was looking to cast the character of Special Agent Gibbs. Number 2. Gibbs's Garments. When he's not playing the part of Special Agent Leroy Jethro Gibbs, Mark Harmon is known for organizing charity events, doing toy drives to help naval-based families, and making appearances for foundations that provide aid to veterans. This has made him a big hit with his fan base, who have taken to sending his way old t-shirts from the armed services to him as gifts. Whenever Gibbs is down in the basement of his home working on his boats, he's often seen wearing t-shirts from the Army, Navy, Marine Corps, and Air Force. At first, these were found by the wardrobe department to add authenticity, but with the help of the fans, all the t-shirts became provided for. At number 1, their desk decor. If you've ever paid attention to the desk decor in the squad room, you'll notice that the personal tastes and hobbies of the main leading characters find their way into their work lives. If you look closely at McGee's desk, you'll see posters for the electronic group Venetian Snares, a band that Sean Murray happens to love as well. Ellie, who showed up in the series in season 11, has a desk area plastered with Oklahoma State University spirit gear, from pendants to class pictures. Actress Emily Wickersham was a student there and wanted a way to give her alma mater a little shout-out. Ladies and gentlemen, that is it for today's video. If you have anything to add to our list of NCIS hidden secrets, let us know in the comments below. Alternatively, if you've learned anything today, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And join us next time for more such informational content. Over and out.